In 586 BC, after defeating the Assyrians, a new Mesopotamian empire invades Israel. The Babylonians ransack the temple and systematically burn the sacred city. Before his eyes, the Babylonian victors slay the sons of Zedekiah, the last Davidic king, then blind him. After 400 years, Israel is wiped out. The Babylonians round up the Israelite priests, prophets, and scribes and drag them in chains to Babylon. Babylonian records confirm the presence of Israelites, including the king, in exile. Without temple, king, or land, how can the Israelites survive? Their journey begins with the ancient scrolls, which some scholars speculate were rescued from the flames of the destruction.
Among the exiles from Jerusalem to Babylon were priests from the temple. And they seem to have brought with them their sacred documents, their sacred traditions.
It is during this period, through the exile, that the exiles realized that even far away from their homeland, without a temple, without the priesthood, without kings, they're still able to worship God, be loyal to God, and to follow God's commandments.
In 539 BC, the Babylonian Empire is toppled by the Persians. As written in the Bible, Yahweh orchestrates a new exodus. Among one group of returning exiles is the prophet Ezra. Back in Jerusalem, he gives a public reading of the written Torah to re-establish the covenant.
All the people gathered together. They told the scribe Ezra to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had given to Israel. He read from it from early morning until midday, and the ears of all the people were attentive to the book of the law. Nehemiah 8, 1 through 3.
To me, it's one of the most moving moments in the whole Bible.